The TERRA mission gives us the opportunity to visualize the impacts of artificial light at night from above the Earth, allowing us to monitor these changes over time. In Texas, we're able to identify the Eagle Ford shell bed from space, showing the lights from oil and gas operations on the ground. We're able to identify the light impact from oil facilities and well flares. It also enables us to see areas where natural darkness may still be found.
Nitrogen dioxide is a gas emitted during the combustion of fossil fuels. It's released from the tailpipes of cars and the smokestacks of power plants. Together, these emissions affect the quality of air we breathe. Since 2004, an instrument aboard NASA's Aura satellite has measured levels of nitrogen dioxide in Earth's atmosphere. In 2014, we released satellite images that show how environmental regulations have led to reductions in nitrogen dioxide over major U.S. cities. Now we created global maps that allow us to see how levels have changed around the world over the last decade. In Western Europe, despite the recent vehicle emissions scandal, nitrogen dioxide levels have decreased by as much as 50% due to tighter environmental controls. In China, we see an increase in levels over most of the country due to a rise in coal use for power generation, but decreases for some cities like Beijing, where a growing middle class is now demanding cleaner air. In the Middle East, we see decreases in nitrogen dioxide levels over Syria due to the country's civil war and displacement of its population. Meanwhile, levels have gone up in neighboring countries where millions of Syrians have taken refuge. In the U.S., the only increases are in regions with intensive oil and natural gas extraction, including fracking. In North Dakota and Texas, we see increases of 30% in some areas. By monitoring levels of nitrogen dioxide from space, we can see and quantify the effects of things like energy usage, environmental policy, and even civil unrest on air quality across the globe.
In late January of 2020, Chinese authorities had shut down transportation going into and out of Wuhan. As the newly identified coronavirus spread and similar quarantines went into effect across China, the nitrogen dioxide dropped significantly.
Black marble has given us a way to visualize humanity's relationship with artificial light at night. In the image, you can see a compilation of 5 years of data from Chicago, showing how light use changed over those 5 years. You can see it more than doubled between 2012 and 2016. It's also allowing us to witness the growth of countries, the borders between them, civil war within those borders, and the impacts of a pandemic.
astronauts have the perfect perspective to view Earth at night. Using a DSLR camera on the space station, they are capturing a snapshot of life on this planet, one photo at a time. These photos are important because they capture the light from blue-white LED lights, which the VIRS satellite cannot pick up. These images give us a more complete view of our relationship with light. A new citizen science project, Lost at Night, aims to help the organization Cities at Night match astronaut photos with cities on the ground. This will allow them to create an interactive map, which will aid in studying the evolution of light pollution and where lighting may be improved to minimize impacts to human health, our ability to see the stars, and our impact on ecosystems around us.